All right, I think I did a good enough job there. By the way, these brushes evidently were made by Daniel 31, Daniel 31 on YouTube. So yeah, I kind of inadvertently advertised him. But he made some awesome brushes, so I might as well. So yeah, there's your bloody theme right here. As an alternative, you could click use color from gradient and then click a gradient here. I'll click abstract one here, and now I'm gonna click right here, and whoa, now we've got paint blotches. Yeah, instead of blood, it could be paint. So that's another alternative that you could have, is have a paint blotch channel, a big textured paint blotch channel. In addition to that, you could also put images in the background, like maybe get some downloaded images off the internet and post them on the background and not on the boxes and stuff like that. So that's an alternative as well. All right, it's time to add some detailing to this. We all know that art is all about the details and the little touches that make it awesome. So now we're going to take a closer examination of my channel here. Now, look at where text goes across the channel. This kind of text that you can click on goes across the bar up to here. There's some stuff over here that automatically goes on the box. There's stuff over here. But what you want to do is look for places that text isn't there. Like, text is not over here to people. Like, you see arrange uploads is over here, but the people that are looking at your channel will not see that. So don't worry about that arrange uploads there. So you can put something here if you want, or this see this the crazy gaming guy thing here with this darker blue color. This darker blue color you cannot get rid of whatsoever. So you can put some detailing underneath this arrow thing here. You can put some detailing between the channel comments and the refresh and edit right here, like around, yeah, there. Yeah, wherever there isn't any text, you can do some extra editing and touches to it. So what I'm going to be doing is zooming in. Oh, not zooming out. I said zooming in. Ugh! And I'm going to zoom in to where that arrow would be on the channel here, and I'm going to put a nice big old blood splotch right there. Actually, maybe I should be zooming out to do this so I can see where the blood splatter is gonna go. Okay, so take a brush, not the circle brush. I was using that to erase some stuff that I got off the edge by mistake. There, for example, if you accidentally get some blood splotches off the edge, just erase it like that. Otherwise, you're gonna have to fade the edge, and then it just won't look as good as if there were to be just dots of blood all over the place. Okay, now I'm going to take another blood brush, this one here. I think it's the first one, and I'm going to make a splatter right across where that arrow would be. The scale is a bit too big, so I'm gonna scale it down to 50. That's good right there. I'm going to okay. I should make a new layer, actually. Make a new layer, just like that, and click on that layer, the new layer, to make sure it's selected, and now put the blood splatter over that layer, just like that. And it'll put some splatter across the field. Oh, maybe I'll take a different brush. Maybe a different brush might be a little better, like a more full brush. Like right there should do it. Yeah. Now, what that'll do is that'll make it look like that there's blood actually on top of the whole thing, which really there is blood on top of the whole thing now, but you can still see the box borderline around it. That's how you add just a tiny bit of detailing just to make it a little bit more awesome than it is right now. Okay, now I'm going to zoom out and I'm gonna put some blood right around here. So I'm gonna grab a paintbrush tool here, and I'm gonna scale it down some more. Yeah, that looks pretty good right there at 23. I'm gonna slap it right over here. Actually, that's bad. Let's try it a little bit lower. Yeah, this is all about playing with things too, by the way. So just keep playing with things and you'll get it. Okay, now I got something like that. Now you see it's on where text would appear on other spots. We don't want that. So what we're gonna do right now is zoom in to where that is and take your eraser tool and big circle, even increase the size of it if you want, and erase it. Just erase it like that, where the boxes are, and it'll blend right in with the other stuff, just like that. Maybe you should even get a fuzzy eraser brush like that, just to make sure that it all blends in neatly. Yeah, and this blend will appear over onto where the channel comments are, right where it would be here. If you have a box set up like you do on, like I do on my channel, like here, I put the channel comments near the top. There will be some blood right around here, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, that's about it for blood detailing. GIMP froze on me, so I had to do this all over again from the very beginning. But anyway, let's continue. And the final thing that I'm going to be doing is giving my channel a little bit of a final detail, so to speak. And I'm going to put my PkGam name right here, right over here. I'm going to show you where I'm going to put it, right on my channel here. See where I got PkGam on here? You can put your name right over here, wherever you want. Now, it's a great way to put a little header to your channel. This arrange uploads will not be showing on other people's pages when they look at your channel, because it's actually a thing that only the channel owner can use. Yeah, so that won't be there, and this PkGam will be in full showing. So you want to make sure that it's slightly to the left of the edge of this thing right here. So I'm going to go back over to GIMP right here. Now I'm going to click the text tool right here, and I'm going to create a really big box. And I mean a really big box here. And I'm going to type in PkGam, like so, without the comma, arg, and without the O, double arg. Dang you, big fingers. Okay. I did want that in black. I'm gonna undo that. I want that in black. Whoopsie daisy. Okay, another big box here. PkGam. Yay. Okay, and now I'm going to enlarge that. Actually, I'm going to hit the enter key a few times to center it on that box there. Okay. Now I'm going to plop it up there, and now I'm going to increase the size of the text itself. I want something really, really bold. Let's look for something bold in the text here. Let's go all the way up to the top. Aharoni bold? Okay, I'll just use that one just because it sounds kind of silly. I don't know. It's probably something that I'm making fun of that I shouldn't be making fun of, but whatever. Now I'm going to increase the size of it like that until it can fill out the entire thing in scale. I'm going to keep going a little bigger. A little bigger. Almost there. I think right there is maybe a little bigger. Yeah, it's all about playing with it, just to make sure you get everything just right. And a little bit bigger. Yeah. Hey, let's get centered. You. A little lower. Okay, right there. Now I'm going to close that, and I'm going to click the text layer in layers here, right here. There's nothing on there like that. Wait, where is the PkGam? I guess that is it. Okay, click alpha to selection, and that'll make a little dotted line appear around the PkGam, just like this. Okay, now click select, shrink by one, just like that, and now fill it in with white. Edit. Wait, where's the fill? Fill with foreground color. There we go. Now we got a little black border around my name there. Now, to finish it off, I'm going to make my name a little bit bloody, just like the rest of it. Click the paintbrush tool, make sure that your texting is selected, and then select a bloody brush, a really, really speckled one, like this one here. Scale it down if you have to. Ooh, that's way too big right there. Still too big. Any day now I'll get it. There we go. That's pretty good. Now just speckle the name just like that with blood wherever you want it. No, it will not appear on the white, so don't worry. It'll only appear where your name is. Whatever is selected on the inside, speckle it and be happy. So, yeah, that's about it. Now we've got a bloody PkGam name right there, and that's about it for this tutorial. Now, all you have to do is click select, and wait, image, flatten image. That'll make everything into one layer, just like that. and select none, and there's your channel template right there. Now all you have to do is save it. Save it whatever you want. I'm going to just save it as, blood is good. actually, I'm going to change the file type though. Change it to a JPEG image, and yeah, just save it like that, and save it at the maximum quality to see what size it's going to be. I'm going to click and go to pictures right here, and channel templates, blood. What's the file size? 1.35 megabyte. Wow, that's way, way, way too big. You got to get the file size under 256 kilobytes. So what you can do with that is to play around with the size of this thing. Like, you can scale it down, just like pull the bottom up and stuff like that to scale it down. And also, when you save it as a JPEG image,